Did you see this garbage that was written today? I almost want to pull it up word for word. Okay. Short synopsis of it. It was reported today that Keith Lee, Otis, Daba Kato, trying to see who else. Keith Lee, Otis, Daba Kato, Dio Madden, and Omos were all sent to the performance center. Now, the funny thing about it is when you were a kid and you went to school, did you ever play the game telephone? Did you ever play the game telephone? While I'm explaining this, could someone right now in the chat room, could you go on PW Insider and use the word that they put in quotations that Vince McMahon sent them there for? It wasn't seasoning. I think it began with the letter R. If someone could go on PW Insider and just tell me the one word that they said. I don't remember. It wasn't seasoning, but someone will pull it up really quick. But anyway, when I was in school, back in like kindergarten, first grade, we used to play a game called telephone. I think I had maybe like 30 kids in this class with me. And what would happen is the teacher would whisper something in the first student's ear. No, it's not, you know, come by after class with only your gym shorts on. No, she would say something like, I had an apple today for lunch. And then, not retraining, it wasn't retraining. No, you're close, keep it real. It wasn't reconditioning. You're very, very close. It wasn't retraining. It wasn't reconditioning. It was very, very close. People are guessing. Just go on PW Insider. It was in parentheses. It was a shorter word. And I might even remember it before someone pulls it up. But you would have 30 students in the school. And you would tell the first student something. And by the time it got to the 30th student, the first person would read on a sheet of paper what the teacher originally told he or she. By the time it got to the third, refine. Thank you, Michael Gonzalez. Could always depend on your brother. Refine. Refining. Okay? Remember the word refine. But you play telephone. Teacher tells the first student. Student tells the next student. Goes down the line till the student 30. By the time you get to the student 30, it says, oh, I'm going to go for pizza after we're done at school today. Hadn't said nothing what the beginning was. The original article this morning was that WWE sent some of the big talents, bigger size talents, to the performance center for some refining. Okay. Do you remember Mission I's discussion a week or two ago about The Undertaker? Remember when Triple H on the media call for NXT and Triple H said that Undertaker may actually come down and actually work with some of the younger guys? You could go back, and I wish I would have done timestamps at that time. I'm too lazy to pull it up now. But I remember specifically saying, if you go back and you watch The Undertaker's documentary, it showed him working in the ring, in a performance center, with some of the big guys. And this was like, whatever it was, 6 months ago, 8 months ago, whatever it was. So refining is not a big deal. Wrestlers refine, they tweak, they this, they that. You know, Vince creatively, you know, has things in his mind that Keith Lee cannot work the NXT style on the main roster. It's not the same. You look at Dijakovic, T-Bar. He doesn't wrestle on the main roster anywhere near what he was doing in NXT. Refining is no big deal. And you would have thought today that people had family members and pets kidnapped. I mean, these people were bitter and angry about how dare they send Keith Lee to the performance at the refining. And then you had the flip side of goofs making fun of Keith Lee. You know, the bottom line with that article today, I mean, I went on my lunch hour and I was just looking online to see what's going on with news. And I even see Twitter. Twitter is so smart. You all probably saw it too. On the right side where it shows trending stuff, there was a paragraph that said, the reports are that WWE sent Keith Lee and others down to the, they're just getting more people to click on it because it's Twitter. That's how they make money. That's how they get out of it. So all of these people out there tweeted 5, 10, 20 times today in an uproar about this. So I'm telling you, in my opinion, this was much ado about nothing. I think back to Steve Austin when he went to the WWE and they were going to do the ringmaster stuff, and then he tweaked his character and they tweaked this and he did this and that. Wrestlers all throughout their career will go back and, you know, try to enhance things, refine things, tweak things, add things. You know, did you see the trend that every single person is a big guy? So WWE sending them there, it's not that they all suck on TV and this is, oh, the writing team should be in the one in the performance center. It's much ado about nothing. Refining turned into reinventing. This was a nothing burger. People losing their shit, whatever side that you were on, losing their shit because how dare they do that to Keith Lee? What are you talking about? When they showed that Undertaker video working out with some of the guys that are on the main roster now, nobody had their balls in a bunch that they were working with the Undertaker. My God. You would want wrestlers to fine-tune, refine, tweak, enhance. You never want to be complacent. So, I honestly, everyone, yes, and you're very welcome for everybody who's writing down the chat. Look, I understand why some fans would really take this the wrong way. But, you know, next time you should look up on Google the definition of refining. It's not anything major. They didn't get demoted. It's refining. It's just tweaking. You know, maybe extending their careers a little bit. Maybe trying to tell them, look, you're not in NXT anymore. You got to work and focus. You're a huge mother. You know, you don't need to do this. You don't need to do that. People all over today, oh, well, Keith Lee has a history of blowing up. All right, so maybe the refining is, Keith, you know, you could do some power moves. You don't always have to leave your feet. Remember Brock Lesnar early on? Remember what he said to Lars early on? You don't leave your feet unless you do a move, you know? I mean, this is like wrestling from the 70s and the 80s and the 90s. There is a formula sometimes with big guys. You know, back in the day, you'd have this huge mountain of a man, and somebody runs the ropes and runs into him, and the other guy falls on the floor, and he just looks. They did it with Hogan in 1979. Look at when Hogan first came into WWF when he was managed by Freddie Blassie. He would wrestle someone, and that person would do everything possible. Hulk Hogan never left his feet until he did the leg drop. And I don't even think he was doing the leg drop at that time. So it's only refining, everyone. It's not a big deal. You know, I think people blew it way out of proportion for various reasons. Some people, look, they get a little offended by this stuff. Some people, I think, just have way too much free time in the day, and I think you should just let it go because in the end, it's only going to make them better. You know, a lot of us think that Vince is out of touch. I am with you. Vince McMahon will never step down. Unless, obviously, somebody comes a-calling from the pearly gates. But the thing is that you look at wrestlers throughout our lifetime being wrestling fans. WWE has made a lot more people than they have destroyed. Yes, once in a while a wrestler would come along and, you know, they don't reach their potential, it doesn't work out, whatever reason. But they have a pretty damn good track record with their wrestlers. The storylines are crappy, but you know, when these wrestlers and they change their style and they refine or they get a new move or they this and that, you think they just dreamt it while they were sleeping? So it's not a big deal, everybody. It's not a big deal.